Welcome at the Wireless Classroom, where you can gather information about wireless systems along with coding examples. If you think this video is helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel, which helps me to produce more content. In today's video, I will explain the topic of inter-symbol interference with illustrative examples. First of all, we have to introduce our basic transmission system with an additive white Gaussian noise channel. At first, the bits B are mapped onto a transmit symbol X. Then the symbol is transmitted over the channel where noise is added. Consequently, we have our received symbol Y, which can be demodulated to the detected bits B prime. The received symbol Y is given by the convolution of the channel with the transmitted symbol plus the noise. Note that the convolution can be replaced by a simple multiplication for flat fading channels. We want to discuss two different scenarios, that is the case of a 1 and a 2 tap channel. Now let's have a look what the different amount of taps mean in a wireless communication system. Let us transmit data from the transmitter to the receiver. In the simplest case, there would only be the direct path, and therefore we have a channel with an impulse response with one tap. If we consider a second path, which has a longer distance than the first path due to reflections, we get a delayed echo of the transmitted signal. This results in an additional tap in the channel. Considering more paths would then result in more channel taps. Note that the channel magnitude does not have to decrease monotonically, as there could be multiple paths with the same delay. Now we are able to discuss the case of a one-tap channel. Generally speaking, the received symbol Y in an AWGN channel is given by the channel convolve with the transmit symbol X plus the noise. The impulse response of the channel for a one-tap channel is given by alpha 0 times the Dirac delta impulse. This impulse is 0 for k equals 0 and 0 otherwise. We want to transmit two consecutive symbols x0 and x1 over our channel H. The received symbol in time domain is given by H convolved with the transmit symbol X plus the noise. The convolution is a representation by the infinite sum starting at j equals minus infinity up to j equals infinity. We can now insert our channel into this sum. Note that the delta from k minus j times x from j can be simplified to x from k, because the only contributing element is k equals j. Consequently, we get the solution to our problem by alpha 0 times x dependent on k plus the noise. Now we can insert our two transmit symbols into this equation and get the final solution. After the first symbol, that means k equals 0, we get y from 0 equals alpha 0 times x0 plus noise. After the second symbol, we have y from 1 equals alpha 0 times x1 plus n. This means that the transmission of a symbol is only dependent on the transmission symbol in the same time slot. Therefore, we have no inter-symbol interference. The behavior of the one-tap channel can also be illustrated with this figure. For the one-tap channel, we only have the direct path. Transmitting x0 will result in a scaling by the channel coefficient alpha 0, ignoring the noise. Transmitting another symbol, x1, behaves similarly. Now we discuss the case of a channel with two tabs. The received symbol is once again given by the convolution of h times x plus the noise. Similar to the previous case, we start by inserting the channel coefficients into this equation. These summations can again be simplified due to the delta impulse. We end up with alpha 0 times x from k plus alpha 1 times x from k minus 1 plus noise. We can now insert the transmit symbol x again. We have now one term with zero delay, that is alpha 0 times x 0, then a combination of alpha 0, x 1, alpha 1 and x 0 with a delay of 1. Additionally, we have alpha 1 times x 1 with a delay of 2 and the noise. Once again, we look at the case after the transmission of the first and second symbol for the two-tab channel. After the first symbol, that is k equals 0, we end up with the same result as before, alpha 0 times x 0 plus n. However, after the second symbol, we get a different result. At the receiver for k equals 1, we see alpha 0 times second transmit symbol plus alpha 1 times the first transmit symbol plus the noise. This means our first transmit symbol interferes with our second transmit symbol at y from 1. This is known as inter-symbol interference. ISI is caused by more channel tabs. These tabs are caused by multipath propagation. So in literature, you speak of multipath-induced fading. Inter-symbol interference can be mitigated by applying an equalizer at the receiver, which will be discussed in another video. The illustration of the two-tab channel is a bit different. Transmitting the first symbol is similar to the previous case. We transmit over the direct path with alpha 0 and therefore receive alpha 0 times x 0, ignoring the noise. However, x 0 will also be transmitted over the second path, alpha 1, which has a delay. The delayed signal over the upper path interferes with our second transmission of x1. Consequently, the second time slot will have the transmission of x1 over the direct path combined with x0 over the upper path. This brings me to the end of this video and the topic of inter-symbol interference. Thank you for watching.